What up? See me, the Samoan scientist, coming at you from my kitchen. And today, I got all this stuff here. To show you, I am making sapasui without meat. So vegetarian, vegan, meatless, whatever you want to call it. So first thing we got is the pot here. Got the fire on. Gonna put in some extra virgin olive oil. Then we're gonna put in our minced garlic. Get that going. And here's a sizzle. There we go. Let's just pour that all in. That in there. And then we got the ginger. What up? What up, Lima? Are you at work on your phone or are you on personal time on your phone? So we got the ginger. Got the garlic in there. Browning, sauteing. While that's going, I'll turn the fire down. I gotta chop up some green onion and some cilantro to get in there. Here's the green onion, nice and fresh. What up, Brown? How you doing, Ooze? See, so we got the green onion now. This is to get all my people healthy, man. Get them from being fat. Stop being fat and gross. All your health problems. You want to be happy and live long? Quit eating all that meat. So, here we go. Bam. Gonna chop this up. Let me let you see how the... Yeah, this is coming along, see? Let's get that olive oil in there. You get this all toasted. Bam. Get it all toasted. You don't want to burn it, so you can take it off the fire too. So bam, there we go. What up, Joyce? It's the Rubios. So here we are again. So like I said, let's get all the dirt part off, the nasty here. Just peel that away. These up. Here we go. Cutting up green onions here, all the way back into the green part. I love the green part of the green onion, not just the onion part on the bottom. So this, I'll throw away. And then I got this, I'll be putting in. So here we go, bam. Use my plate as a cutting board. Put that back on the fire. So we got the green onion in there now. Now we're gonna go for the cilantro. We got fresh cilantro here. This is really good in sapasui. So let's get this wound up a little right here. Wind it up and then chop it up. Fresh cut here. Get everyone eating healthy. I got a surprise for you as I show you as we keep going on this. So I'm not gonna use it all. Oh, you put this back. That's good, go in the fridge. Got the green onions for the fridge. I've already done the ginger. So the green onions in, here's the cilantro. Here we go, bam. Use a cutting plate. Then we also have some celery, pre-cut. I was lazy on this because I didn't want to get a whole stalk of celery. So I got some celery I'll put in here. Give some good flavor. Chris, just eat. It's good. We're gonna add the beyond meat. Got the bean noodles. Bean sprouts. Broccoli. Green beans and some portobello mushrooms. This is gonna be like the meat part as well as this. So we'll see. You know what? I'm gonna skip the portobello mushrooms this time since I got the Beyond Meat. So I'm gonna put this away. What up, Steven? It's the family. You got a lot of family watching this time. Let's put that away. And then I'm always drinking on something good too. Got the grapefruit juice. No more that big things of tang. Cut out that sweetness. So here we go with the stir stick. The fire's on over here. Ooh, starting to smell really good. Get that going. Let that get in there. This is soy sauce I like to use. So we got these things left. As soon as that starts to cook down, you can hear it sizzling. As soon as it cooks down, we'll take it and add the rest of the stuff. I probably should add the meat now so it can brown good and get good flavor with that. So I'm gonna add the Beyond Meat. This is 20 gram, oh, that's the plant based, so this is 1 pound. It was $10 at Vaughn's. I picked it up yesterday. Here we go. See, smells similar to meat. Looks similar to ground beef. Once we get it in there, we'll see how it breaks up and goes. So let me put, oh man, my spoon fell in. Get the gloves, bust out with the gloves here. Keep sanitary. People, so here we go. You can hear this sizzling. Looking good. Get tender. Really good here. Medium high heat. Let's get this Beyond Meat in. Drop it in there. Little chunks. Easy to spread around. Make it look like hamburger meat. Although I've never had hamburger meat in my sapasui, but hey, See? Hamburger. Looks just like it. But no meat. So we'll get this in here and get it stirred around. Get it to brown a little. Then we'll start adding the suo, which we got vegetable broth. Stirred. Ooh-wee, excuse me. So here we go. Let me show you guys what it's looking like. Hear the sizzle, see the sizzle. Nice color. All right, so we're gonna let that cook up while, you do, let me put this away. We haven't opened it, so I'll put it back here. Get this stir. What the hell? Get that going. Let me put my stuff away that I'm not using. What up, John? Can I wave back? Did I touch the wave button on you guys? I thought I did. Here we go. Yep, there we go. What up, people? What up? So we're going to put these away back in the fridge to keep them fresh. Put them in the vegetable drawer because it's at the humidity again. We still got to put the bean sprouts in, which is really healthy for you. We got green beans, which, you know, green, very healthy. We all know about the broccoli being healthy. This is just to keep it healthy instead of using water, which water is okay, but water's got no flavor, and I don't want to use the tap water. I got 10 plus water, you know, the alkaline, but that's for drinking, so, you know. I'll use the, I'm going to make bean, some chili again next, and I got another pound of that Beyond Meat, and I'm going to use it instead. I'll do that one again next, next time I cook. Well, let's get this stirred up again. Layers upon layers of flavor here. There's a lot of salt in the meat, so I don't add any salt. I don't need seasoning because I'm using all fresh ingredients in the season itself. You got the garlic, the ginger, the green onions, the cilantro. Then you got the meat itself that's got seasoning in it and stuff. Then you got all the other ingredients plus the vegetable broth, the soy sauce. So, you know, that's how it's gonna be. Get this thrown away and keep your area clean when you cook, and everything will be nice. So here, let's put this here so you guys can see it. This is what we got left. Let's turn this a little bit right there, so you can hear it sizzling still. It's doing really good in here. So this looks nice. So we got this really nice. So from here, let's add let's go with the suo. Shake it up real good. Low sodium. Cut back in that salt. There we go. And just pour it in the whole thing, because you're gonna cook it down anyway. And when you put the saifun noodles in, the bean noodles are gonna absorb a lot of that. Back in the day, my mom taught me we would get a bowl and we'd put the noodles in it with water, and then they absorb the regular water, and then you cut it up and you put it in there. No, I don't do that. I want the noodles to have the flavor of what's in here, what I'm cooking, so I take the noodles from the package directly into the suya, and then I let it, you know, build up in there and get thick and heavy. Then it tastes like what you're eating and not like bland water. And then when you're done and it sits overnight, when you go to eat leftovers, your stuff's real watery because it comes out. When you got the oils and everything in there from the sewer, from the vegetable broth. Man. So now we're gonna put this in. Boom. Got those three. And I bought more vegetable broth because you never know how much you're gonna need. I put two bags of this. This probably gonna last me 2-3 days. So put those in. I'll let you guys look at that. What up, family? Look at my family over there in New Zealand. Tuning in, Rod, Beetha, yeah. So here we are, we got the noodles I just put in, the bean noodles, we got the suya, the vegetable broth, we got the Beyond Meat, green onions, the cilantro, garlic, ginger, and now we got the noodles. Next, it's gonna be the vegetables. I'll give it a stir. Once I give it a stir, get those noodles starting to absorb the suya. So there we go. Put that in there. Then we're gonna put some of these in there, not the whole bag, just enough. We'll start with a handful like this. Maybe two of those. Like that. That's really good and healthy for you. The beans. I'm going to use all the green beans here. And I'm definitely going to have to put them out here. The ones I do, I'm going to cut them because they come pretty long and I don't want long ones. About half the size of what how they come. So see, that's what it looks like. That's how long they are. So I'm gonna cut these up, line them up, and just do a quick cut. Not get all fancy and specific here. Use my paper plate cutting board. Don't need to dirty up the boards and then washing. Just use a plate and throw it away when you're done. So we're gonna go here like this. These beans kind of lined up as good as I can and get a chop there, and a chop there. And then just drop them in. You see, it's about not as big anymore. See, not full length. Then we'll pour these in. Bam. Do it again. I want more of those. Green beans, very healthy for you. So I'm gonna go like this. Here, do another rough cut with a big ass butcher knife. There, dump these in, bam. Just got that. And, wind this down. And then the broccoli, the whole bag is gonna go in. So we just go like this. There you go. I'm gonna break this one up. See some big ones, break them up. Okay. Now, I'll use this bean bag to hold the rest of these. Nice. And put this in the drawer. The only thing left now is this. So let's give this a stir. Nice and hot, steaming. The Beyond meat looks good. Looks like hamburger meat. Let's go on there. Stir it up. Move it around. Man, it smells good. Like this. Then I'm just gonna keep doing this for a long period of time. Put the lid on it. Let me show you where I'm at. Here we go. So I'll put this in too right now as we're looking, and you can see how it's looking. Right there. So we're gonna take this little choy here and just start dumping it in there for flavor. Get that in there. And when you don't use water, you don't need as much soy sauce and everything else. See, I didn't even put seasoning salts or anything in there, like that Santeria I like to use. So let me go ahead and mix this up again, and then I'm gonna let you guys go so I can worry about this and let this simmer, and then I'll come back at you and show you the end result. And I still gotta make some rice. May need more suwa, but we'll see. Keep the noodles down in the suwa, push them down. Then we're gonna put the lid on this and let it steam. Turn the fire on low so nothing burns. And check it and stir it every 10 to 15 minutes. And then in about about 45 minutes to an hour, it's ready to serve. So I'll be checking you guys out later. Sapasui here at Simi, the Samoan Scientist's Kitchen. Putting together good work. You know, the science in this kind of cooking is making sure you got the right vegetables and the right things in there. And not just that, also for you. So that's what we're at. Sapasui without meat. Yeah.